Creating an Amazon machine image of a customized application server is the next step in deploying a SharePoint website in the Amazon Web Services cloud. You should have already launched the network, Active Directory, and database stacks for SharePoint, as we demonstrated in the previous videos in this series. This video shows you how to manually create a customized AMI of a SharePoint application server, starting from a standard AMI of Windows Server 2008 R2 English 64-bit base for CloudFormation. Creating the database server AMI is the first stage of launching the application stack for a SharePoint farm on AWS. The details of all these procedures are spelled out in the companion document. Start by launching the AMI of Windows Server 2008 R2 English 64-bit base from the Quick Launch Wizard in the EC2 Instances console. Launch the standard AMI as a standalone EC2 instance outside of the virtual private cloud infrastructure you've created so far, but in the same region. We're using US East, Northern Virginia. Name the instance app-standalone. Select m1.small as the instance type and accept the defaults for the rest of the choices. When the instance is launched, it's displayed in the EC2 Instances console. You can view all the instance's parameters under the Description tab. Next, use Remote Desktop Connection to connect to this instance. To do this, right-click the instance in the EC2 Instances console and click Connect. Click the Retrieve Password link, choose the private key file you previously created, and click Decrypt Password. Copy and save the decrypted password. Click Download Shortcut File. Click the downloaded shortcut file to open a remote desktop connection to the app standalone instance. Log into the instance with the password. To get the instance ready to be made into a new AMI, you have to configure it. First, change the Windows Server default settings to allow Internet Explorer to download from the Internet. In Control Panel under Programs, click Turn Windows Features On or Off. Server Manager opens. Under Security Information, click Configure IEESC. Under Administrators, click the Off button to turn off enhanced security configuration and allow downloads. Now download SharePoint Server 2010 for Internet Sites Enterprise from the Microsoft Download site. You can get the link from the companion document. Create a /SharePoint_install directory and extract the SharePoint installation files to it, but don't install them yet. To do this, open a command prompt, move to the directory with the downloaded SharePoint executable, and run sharepointserver.exe /extract:, /SharePoint_install. Next, download the PowerShell scripts module for SharePoint, spmodule.zip, from the Microsoft download site. Again, you can get the link from the companion document. Extract the contents of the zip file to the directory indicated in the document. Add the paths to the PowerShell module to the system environment variables. In Windows Explorer, right-click Computer and click Properties. Click Advanced System Settings and then Environment Variables. Under System Variables, not User Variables, select the PS Module Path Environment Variable and click Edit. Edit the value to point to the location where you copied the files. Next, change a setting for the configuration service of Elastic Compute Cloud. Open the config.xml file for EC2 config service in a text editor and manually reset the EC2 handle user data flag to enabled. Finally, run the EC2 config service settings application from the start menu. When EC2 config service settings opens, click the Image tab and then click the Shutdown with SysPrep button to package the changes. When SysPrep is finished and the app standalone instance shows as stopped in the EC2 management console, create a new Amazon machine image from it. On the Instances page, right-click the instance and click Create Image, EBSAMI. Record the AMI ID of this new AMI displayed in the EC2 management console to use in the following steps. Name the new AMI APP. You've now created a custom SharePoint application server AMI that can be used to launch a SharePoint application server stack with CloudFormation. The next step in deploying a SharePoint website in the Amazon Web Services Cloud is the second stage of Step 3, using the SharePoint Application Server AMI to launch the application stack.